Hey guys, hello again. It's been a long while. Yep, it's another one of those videos where I say, it's been a long while. That was the last video I actually made before this one on YouTube. It was like, hey, it's been a long time since I made that video. So I'm gonna try to make this video be the last time I ever do that. I don't intend to be on a YouTube hiatus for that long again. That video was about a year and a half ago almost, so it's been a long time. And you know, I don't know why, I just didn't feel like talking in front of the camera and talking about my thoughts and my life and stuff like that for a long while. But now I'm back in the mood, so here I make a quick update about my life, and I'm gonna make it as quick as possible. But a lot did happen in the course of a year. Let's see, where do I begin? I'll begin with me finding a job at the homeless shelter. So, that was a year ago, over a year, and so I got employed, June 2011? So, yeah, June 2011, homeless shelter hired me as a community technician. That's what they called us. It's a weird name. It makes us sound like we're tech geeks or something, but we're not. We're more like, we're typically like program assistants or resident assistants. I worked overnight shift, so I pretty much watched homeless people sleep, made sure they didn't have heart attack in their sleeps, and things like that. And when they wake up, you know, I escorted them to breakfast and made sure they had a good breakfast, and come back and give them the tool, like toiletries they needed, and you know, typical, just working in a homeless shelter. I worked a lot of hours, more than my overnight shift, because it's a 24/7 operation. So when a staff of the next shift calls out, somebody of the previous shift or this shift, my shift, would have to stay to do their shift. So in my year working at that shelter, I did a lot of double, like 16-hour shifts, a lot, and a lot of times back to back. My average work week, I worked on average like 70 hours a week. That's how many overtime I did. And some weeks I did 100 hours, 110 hours. It's amazing how many hours I worked at that place. That job, that homeless shelter, like I spent more time in that shelter than I did at my home. Way more time. I just wish I could have slept there, because then, I don't know, then I would have woken up, do my 16-hour shifts, sleep there and do my 16-hour shifts, but that was the toughest thing, doing those 16-hour shifts. So I did a lot of work. During that time, I did have some, I guess, relationship adventures. I did have a girlfriend for the first time in my life, for about 3 months. She was really cool. I got hooked up, like the co-worker hooked me up, because she was my ex-girlfriend now. My ex was a friend of his girlfriend, so he hooked us up, and it went from there. You know, she was a gamer girl too, so we kind of had a really good share similar interest there. So I always had fun with her, but it came to that point, like after 3 months or 2 months, I don't know how long it was, but it's just like I don't feel that way towards her, you know, that like romantic attraction too. So I'm the jackass that broke that relationship off. And then I guess many months later, I did date one other person. She was actually a coworker when we first met each other, but she quit after her first month. And then we kind of were still friends after she quit. Eventually, like, one time we hung out, and I don't know how it came out or why it came out, but I was just like, you know, oh, I always found you attractive. And she was like, oh, me too. And then, so we dated for a while. But that didn't really go anywhere, because she has this philosophy of meeting a partner that has these specific qualities, and I didn't fit into that. So that didn't work out. And we ended it amicably. She remained friends, but I just felt it too awkward to remain as friends, so I kind of I just kind of backed out of that one. So that's been like my relationship wise stuff. Now, I no longer work at the shelter. I was fired like 3 months ago. That's a whole other story altogether, but that put me back on. That put me back to being like unemployed and job searching. Except this time, this unemployment felt like a really awesome vacation. I mean, it was stressful because job searching again was pretty tough. I wasn't able to find a job until very recently, like 2 weeks ago. But yeah, the reason is because, like I said, I worked so many overtime hours that when I cashed out all my benefits, I had enough money to just be like today, well, without having a job, to last till now. So that was pretty amazing, just being able to just, you know, just chill at my home without a job. It was like being a kid again, on Saturday afternoon mornings, and every morning was Saturday morning. So that's been my life so far. Recently, I now found a job as a canvasser, which is like being a fundraiser. I go door to door, I knock on people's homes, and I'm just like, hey, here's some information about the, well, I don't say it like this, I have to be more charming than that, but, and there's actually stuff that we say. But anyway, the gist of it is, like, this is what's going on in this country right now. It's a serious issue. Our organization is working to fix this issue, and we need your support. So I go, and then I give them the information, and I get them to donate money, contribute money. So and that fund goes to the organization. So I'm working on behalf of nonprofit organization as a fundraiser. So that's my job right now. It's a pretty interesting job. It really bolsters it. It affects my confidence level in a way because I really have to get out there and just be charismatic as much as I can be. So it's a challenge for me because I haven't been ever used to that. Also, the biggest challenge is staying good at it. I have to work so hard to be good at that job because I have to meet a quota. So there's a fundraising quota I have to meet every week. If I don't meet it in 2 weeks in a row, I lose my job. So this is a merit-based job too. My pay is reflected on how well I do. If I raise well above my quota, any money I raise above my quota, 30% of it is mine. So it's an interesting it's an interesting salary to work on, to be paid for how well I do, and to keep my job because I do my job well. That's a concept that is still kind of new to me, because before, you know, as long as I went to work on time, did my hours, and followed the company rules, I had my job, and I got a steady pay rate. That was it. This job is different. Even if I do all that, I could still lose my job. I have to not only work my hours and follow company rules, but I have to be damn good at it. And if I do good at it, I get recognized. Promotion in this new job I'm at is ridiculous. My assistant director is like younger than me, and she's only worked at the company for like 3 months or 2 months or whatever. And she's an assistant director that started out as a canvasser. So promotions are ridiculous in this place. So I'm hoping to, you know, be awesome at this job and maybe get myself promoted that high too. Don't know. But that's been my life so far. And already it's 9 minutes, so I'm going to end my quick update there.